everyone. Hope you're having a great day so far. Wanted to hop on and I was really praying to God today. I was like, God, what is on your heart this morning for all of us? And I really felt like God was bringing up this principle of repentance and discipleship as a reminder to all of us who are already in the body of Christ today. You know, I think that a misconception, especially in the American church, is that if we say that one-time prayer and we give our lives to Jesus, that, you know, that's all that's expected, that's all that we should do with our lives. You know, we can keep living like the world, we can keep doing all this stuff, and that's not what the Bible says, you guys. The Bible talks about not just raising up believers, but the importance of raising up disciples and walking in that narrow path, that narrow way that gets us to heaven. You know, we learn a lot about anticipated traffic numbers just by reading what the Bible has to say about those who go to heaven and those who go to hell. You know, if there's a highway to hell and there's a staircase to heaven, you know, and if there's, you know, it says that many will go to hell one day. You know, that should scare us a little bit, you guys. That should be something that we take seriously. The Bible describes it as a narrow path, a narrow way to get to heaven. And this is not me trying to rebuke you or to condemn you this morning, but this is me trying to say that, you know, we need to take it seriously when the Bible says that there's a narrow path, there's a narrow way to get there, and not to just take for granted what Jesus has done for us on the cross, especially on a day like today, you guys. And so Matthew 3:8 is a good reminder to all of us, and it says, produce fruit in keeping with repentance, okay? And so what does that word repent mean? Repent means to give up your former ways, to give up your sin, to give up that old lifestyle, and to lay it down and to say, Jesus, I want to follow you now. You know, I want to do my best to try to follow the Bible as closely as I can in my personal life so that I can please you. I accept your love. I accept what you've done for me, but I'm going to choose to follow you now. I'm going to choose to give up this old lifestyle. And what I fear is I see so many quote unquote Christians, especially in Americanized Christianity, who their lives look exactly like the world. You know, they have not made God the Lord of their life. They believe that God exists, but they have not made God the Lord of their life. And the Bible doesn't talk about just believing in God. You know, even the devil believes in God. Okay, you know, but God says, if you want to be worthy, you've got to take up your cross and follow after me. You've got to make me the Lord of your life. You've got to allow me to call the shots, you know, and thankfully God wants what is best for us, and his plans for us are way better than even our own plans for our life. But so many Christians are not walking in discipleship. They're not walking in a place of repentance. You know, they're just wanting their get out of jail free card when they pray the sinner's prayer, and they're calling that it. And that's not what the Bible talks about. The Bible says produce fruit in keeping with repentance. The Bible talks about making God the Lord of your life. The Bible talks about not just raising up believers, but raising up disciples. And I want to show you this today. This is a really good one. This is Luke 9, verses 23 through 24. And he said to all, if anyone would come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever would save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will save it. And I think that is so critical, you guys. If we're not willing to surrender everything to God, every area of our lives to God, if we're not really able to make him the Lord of our life, this scripture says, you know, we're not worthy of him, you guys. And so it's so critical for us. A disciple is someone who chases after Jesus and who follows the same path that he took. They follow the same lifestyle. They let God call the shots in their life. And so many Christians want a little bit of Jesus, and then they want complete control over their lives. They still want to live in sin. They still want to do whatever they want. When Jesus tells them something they don't like, they'd rather go with their own opinion over God's way. And this is dangerous, you guys. The Bible talks about that that's not going to be a good path to go down. That's a very dangerous path to go down, ladies and gentlemen. I also wanted to read you a little bit more. So this is Luke 14:33, and it says, so likewise, whoever of you does not forsake all that he has cannot be my disciple. So if the Bible talks about making God the Lord of our life, if the Bible talks about repentance, and if the Bible talks about discipleship, this scripture that I just read says, whoever is not willing to forsake all, to give it all up to Jesus, to lay their entire life down to God, it says that we cannot be his disciple. So the Bible doesn't just talk about raising up believers. That's a good first step, believing that Jesus died for you on the cross, but then it was never supposed to end there, you guys. We are called to a journey of discipleship. We are called to a journey where we lay our lives down for the Lord. Say, God, you're the one who calls the shots, because I know you want what's best for me. And so, God, I choose to make you the Lord of my life. I will take up my cross. I will follow after you, Lord Jesus. And that, you guys, is the way that's going to help you to get to heaven one day, ladies and gents. So I really want to caution us to not just, you know, take what Jesus did for us lightly for granted on the cross. He died for your sins. He loves you. His sacrifice was the best thing in the entire world, you guys. But we were never just meant to pray some little prayer and be done and continue living like the world, looking like the world, acting like the world. You know, that's never gonna work well for us, you guys. We are called to accept everything that Jesus did for us. And if we truly want to see success, we need to give our whole lives and lay it down and become a disciple of Jesus Christ. You know, John the Baptist in the Bible wasn't even willing to baptize people until they were willing to make a very firm commitment to repent of their sins, to give up this old lifestyle, to say, Jesus, you're it now. Like, my old life has been crucified, my old self, my old ways has been crucified with Christ, and now I'm going to embrace that I'm a new creation, and I need to walk like I'm a new creation. And so if you guys are hearing this, and if you look at your life and you go, man, you know, I've believed in Jesus, but my life the last few years has just felt very off course, what I want you to do is shoot me an email to jillsharpministries@gmail.com, and I would love to pray with you guys. And I want you to be really introspective and to take this seriously today, you guys. You know, Jesus said, you know, you cannot be my disciple. You are not worthy of me unless you're willing to forsake father, mother, sister, brother. And that's not saying you have to give up your family. What it is saying is you've got to pick Jesus first above everything else in your life. And you've got to be willing to make him the Lord of your life, ladies and gentlemen, to truly repent. It is a lifestyle change that God expects from us. Amen. And so, you know, God doesn't do that to be mean either, you guys. You've got to understand God's heart behind this. God knows that when we surrender to his will for our lives and when we let him call the shots, that's what's going to protect us. That's what's going to help us to walk in the most joy. That's what's going to bring us to a place where we're going to be the most fruitful with our lives. But we've got to be willing to embrace that place of surrender. Amen. And so this is a call to people who believe in Jesus. God never said just raise up believers. That's never intended to be where we stop. That's the first step. God said to repent. And then after we lay down that old lifestyle, after we lay down our sins, he said, then I want you to be a disciple. A disciple is someone who follows in the footsteps of someone else and who models their lifestyle in the same way that Jesus does. And that's why we got to be in our Bibles on a regular basis, y'all. We cannot know how to live if we are not in the handbook, quote unquote, on a regular basis and receiving instruction from the Lord so that we can walk in that narrow way that he has for our lives. So again, if you heard this and you feel like, man, you know, I've been believing in Jesus, but my lifestyle has just not been great, I want you to shoot me an email. Again, jillsharpministries@gmail.com. I would love to pray with you guys. I hope you have a wonderful Sunday. Let's all praise Jesus for what he's done for us on the cross and that he is risen again. Amen. Hope you guys have a great day. I'll talk to you soon.